Good morning, Warriors. Welcome back. I'm Zach Bowen.
And I'm Jaden Boggs.
And here's your Warrior news for the week of August 29th.
We'll talk with Mr. Walmer and Ms. Perry. We'll have upcoming sports, breakfast, and lunch menus, announcements, pop culture, and the August birthdays.
Let's start the week off with a Pledge of Allegiance and a moment of silence.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Now for the announcements.
The National Guard recruiter will be outside the cafeteria every Monday, so if you have any interest in that, make sure to stop by during lunch.
We'd also like to welcome our new nurse, Brenda Bowers.
For the staff book club is starting up soon, so if you're interested in that, make sure to contact Ms. Fowl by September 2nd. Now here's Jet with Pop Culture.
Hi, my name is Jet Redbogle, and let's see what's happening this week for Pop Culture. The movie Beast is now in theaters. Dr. Nate Daniels and his two teenage daughters travel to a South African reserve. However, what begins to be a journey of healing soon turns into a fearsome fight for survival when a bloodthirsty lion begins stalking them. I remember seeing this trailer when I watched the third Jurassic World movie, and it looked really good, so go and see it. Marvel Studios' She-Hulk Attorney at Law is dropping new episodes every Thursday on Disney+. It stars Tatiana Maslany playing Jennifer Walters, a lawyer by day, hero at night, cousin of Bruce Banner, also known as the Hulk. Navigating the complicated life of a single 30-something attorney who also happens to be a green 6'7" superpowered Hulk. You can stream it now on Disney+. For celebrity news, Will Smith has returned to social media, posting a video of a tarantula a few feet away from him. This is his first post since the Chris Rock slap incident that I assume you've heard of. This was after the Chris Rock apology. Back to the studio.
Thanks, Jet. Now here's Sydney with the breakfast and lunch menus.
Hi, I'm Sydney Ewing, and here's the breakfast and lunch menus for the week of August 29th. All food items are subject to change. I'm hungry, are you? Here's the breakfast menu. Tomorrow, yogurt parfait. Wednesday, biscuits and gravy. Thursday, sausage, egg, and cheese croissant. Friday, breakfast pizza. And next Monday is Labor Day, so there will not be breakfast. Now moving on to the lunch menu. Today, beef teriyaki bites or hot dog. Tomorrow, French toast sticks with sausage patty or egg patty or taco with salsa. Wednesday, mac and cheese with garlic breadstick or Mexican pizza. Thursday, chicken tenders with sauce or corn dog. And Friday, calzone or barbecue rib sandwich. Enjoy this week's breakfast and lunch, and thank you to the cafeteria staff for doing an amazing job. Back to the studio.
Thanks, Sydney. Now here's Braxton with the sports schedules.
Hello, this is Braxton Gonzalez, and here is the sports schedule for the week of August 29th. All schedules are subject to change. Tonight, the JV and varsity volleyball teams will host the Goshen Blue Blazers. The freshman team serves at 5 p.m. Varsity girls golf hosts Fairfield and Elkhart. Tee time is 5:30 p.m. And then the varsity boys soccer travels to Mishawaka. Kickoff is at 6:30 p.m. Tomorrow, the volleyball teams will travel to Manchester. First serve is at 6 p.m. The boys varsity tennis team will host Wicco. The first serve is at 5 p.m. The cross-country team competes in the NLC round-robin meet at Goshen. Meet starts at 6 p.m. The Unified Flag football team will host Carroll High School. Kickoff is at 6 p.m. Wednesday, the girls' varsity golf will host Northwood in Mishawaka. Tee time is 5 p.m. Thursday, the volleyball teams host Plymouth. First serve is at 5:30 p.m. Girls' varsity golf travels to Goshen. Tee time is 5 p.m. Boys' varsity tennis travels to Concord. First serve is at 5 p.m. Then the freshman football team hosts DeKalb. Kickoff is at 6 p.m. For Friday, the varsity football team will host Goshen. Kickoff is at 7 p.m. Saturday, boys' soccer teams travel to Plymouth to compete in the Blueberry Tournament. The tournament starts at 10 a.m. Girls' soccer teams travel to Goshen. Kickoff at 11:45 a.m. JV football will travel to Goshen. Kickoff at noon. Cross country travels to Manchester. Invitational meet starts at 8 a.m. Finally, the boys' varsity tennis team hosts the varsity super duels. First serve at 9 a.m. Good luck, Warriors.
Thank you, Braxton. Now here's an interview with Jaden and Miss Perry.
Good morning, everyone. With me, I have Miss Perry, the JAG teacher here at the high school. For the people that don't know what JAG stands for, it's Jobs for American Graduates. First thing I would like to say is congratulations, Miss Perry, on moving in the next couple of weeks. I hope all goes well for you. With you moving, what should some of the students expect? Have you heard anything about who the new teacher will be?
Sure, thank you, Jaden. Yes, my husband did accept a new position in Michigan, so we will be moving there in mid-September. As far as student expectations, you can really expect the same consistency that JAG's always been able to provide. I will very much be part of the interview process and the training process for this new person, so all hopes are that it goes very smoothly, and I feel like it's definitely going to.
Alrighty, amazing. So just a couple simple questions for you. So why should students take your class here at the high school?
They should take this class because I feel like it's really important that we care about our future. This class prepares you for life after high school, so we really try to touch base on everything post-secondary. So whether that means college, you entering the workforce, skills trade, maybe taking some time off, or maybe even joining the military. Whatever that could be for you, we try to look into those options, and we try to make it very student-specific. That's why these classes tend to be a little bit smaller, so we can really figure out what you're interested in and then connect you with those resources. We go out into the community. We learn about what different employers have to offer. We also have guest speakers come in. We have college admissions people come in. We have employers come in. Just so everyone is aware what the various options are for life after high school.
Do you have anything to tell us about your class? Like, what really makes it stand out?
Sure. We are a very non-traditional class. We are very interactive. We're kind of always moving, always going places, always doing group work. So definitely it's a little non-traditional in that sense. But also we do offer incentives because we are a state-funded program. That means anytime you reach one of your goals in the program, if it is written in your plan, then I can give you a financial incentive for meeting that. And that incentive obviously has to be earned. We're not just giving it away. So it is, for example, say I sat down with a student and we said, okay, the GPA really needs to go up. We would set a goal for maybe reaching a GPA of like a 0.5 increase. And if that goal is met by the end of the year, then the state would allow me to give that student a kind of like a reward, so like a financial incentive for meeting that goal.
All right, Ms. Perry, what does your class entail?
Sure, so we go through 37 core competencies that make up the JAG program. These competencies are kind of grouped A through F, and it goes through, you know, basic job attainment skills, job retention skills, social skills, personal skills, all of that. So there's 37 core competencies, and those are broken down into different levels. So level one is me just teaching it and the student learning it. Level two would be the student practicing it, and then level three would be the student mastering it. So at the end of the year, the student would have mastered all 37 employability skills, at three different levels. So that's really what the goal is to be able to finish the program by completing all of those competencies.
Yeah, that's actually really amazing. You guys do fit a lot of things into a short amount of time for that semester.
Sure.
Do you have a JAG mission statement?
Yes, JAG's mission statement is to empower the nation's youth with skills and support to succeed in employment, education, and in life in general.
With the school just starting back up, how are you encouraging students to take your class?
Sure. Most referrals come just by teachers or through guidance counselors, but I also do things like freshman orientation and chats during warrior time to kind of get people familiar with the program.
This year, what do you have to say to your students that are in your classes?
Sure, I would just say work hard. You know, you don't wake up one day and just suddenly have willpower. You do have to create that for yourself. So working hard, I think, is the best thing. Also to just love yourself, to really get what you want out of life, to really put the effort into thinking critically about what you might want to do after high school.
Alrighty, well, thank you, Ms. Perry, for telling us a little bit more about you and your classes.
Of course, thank you for having me.
Alrighty, and now back to the studio. Thank you, Ms. Perry. Here's an interview with Braxton and Mr. Walmer.
Hello, Mr. Walmer.
Hey, Braxton.
How has the beginning of the school year been for you?
It's actually been a lot better than I had anticipated. So it's been good. Very, very good. How about for you?
Tiring.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's been exhausting lately. But hey, I got all straight A's.
Good. Attaboy. Attaboy.
So, Mr. Walmer, I want to start this off by asking you, what do you have to say to seniors hoping that this will be a quote-unquote normal high school year, considering our track record with COVID shutdowns and trends destroying bathrooms and stealing school property?
I'm with you. And, you know, you deserve it. This senior class is a lot of fun, and I'm glad that you get to walk into this year. Besides the semester schedule, all things else being somewhat normal. And, you know, to that, I would say seniors, you know, obviously you're the oldest in the building. You're the leaders. And what I would ask of seniors is to be the type of leader that the underclassmen actually respect. Ones that they actually look at and say, gosh, man, like, I would like to be like that when I'm a senior. Like, be that kind of leader. Don't be the leader, well, I'm a senior, so you have to do this, or you need to go away because this is seniors only, or you have to. That's not being a leader. That's just being a jerk. So what I ask of the senior class are to be leaders in which others want to follow, because that's what a leader is. A leader is someone that others want to follow. A leader isn't someone that makes others follow them.
What advice do you want to give to incoming freshmen this year?
Now, I told them that the freshman orientation, and then again in our class meeting, the most important thing you can do in this school for anybody in any school is to get involved. You know, Braxton, I know you've been involved in choir, you know, early on football, theater, and it plugs you into a family. It just gives you a connection, and it gives you something to aspire for. Like, I know I have to get good grades because I want to be in this play. I want to be able to sing at the concert. I want to do this and that. So when you're part of something, it actually causes you to do better in school and in your grades because you actually want to do that. So one, get involved. Two, freshmen, don't get caught up in the drama. We've already had some this year, and I look at it and think, you know, and it's every year, you just know it. We're going to have freshmen that come in acting like they did in middle school. And I would love to one day have a year where we didn't have that. So two, don't get caught up in drama. And three, freshman credits count. You know, your grades and your classes right now, they count. And if you fail classes this year, you will have to take them again, which means you won't get to take a class later on that you really want to take because you have to take algebra again, or you have to take English again because you failed it the first time around. So credits count, pass the classes that you're in.
What are you looking forward to most this school year?
As I reflected back on last year, I spoke to this at graduation a little bit. Thinking back to the pride that I feel when I see students achieve in ways that are just amazing, and staff as well. We have some phenomenal staff members here, teachers that are recognized sometimes at the state level, they're recognized at the local level. They're amazing people. But walking away from, you know, a concert last year, walking away from the musical, you know, walking away from sectional championships, like seeing the smiles on the kids' faces and what it does for our community, that to me is what I look forward to every year, and especially this year. You know, I say that, that's the always. Then the other thing is what I talked about again on Friday in seeing people achieve at levels they did not think was possible, and seeing the growth in our school, both academically and through the culture of it. To me, culture is a big, big thing, and having a school that people want to come to, that other schools around us say, why are people at Wawasee, like, they just seem to get along. They seem to, it just is a good culture. What's with it? Why? What's different with their culture? What is it? That's the kind of school that I want to be, and I know that we'll get there as well. So seeing the growth in our school through you guys and through the culture is what I look forward to.
Thank you for watching Warrior News this week. Signing off, I'm Zach Bowen.
And I'm Jaden Boggs.
And from all the people working here in the CPG-TV studios, we thank you for watching.
See you next week for more Warrior News.